Almost a third of Australian home loan holders are right now under mortgage stress. That means they're spending up to 45% of their income on repayments. But with inflation now easing for a third month in a row, there are hopes that outgoing RBA boss Philip Lowe might finish his term with good news when the board meets this week. For more, let's bring in Ratecity Research Director Sally Tindall. Morning, Sally. What do you think will happen at this week's meeting?
Well, it's such a nice feeling, Jane, to say with about 96.5% certainty that we're going to see yet another hold. That'll be the third hold in a month. The data tells the story. Let's look at it quickly. Retail trade went up ever so slightly, 0.5. Some are saying it's a World Cup bounce. I think there's a little bit of a Barbie bounce in that. Yep. But when you look at it per person and you take into fact that prices have gone up, you know, we're not splashing the cash at the shops. That's good. Unemployment up to 3.7, but that's no reason to hit the alarm bells. It just shows that businesses are tightening the screws. And then inflation, the big one, 4.9% this month. We're in the fours. This is fantastic. It's still too high, but, you know, we are making really good progress here, and so I think we're shaping up for another pause.
Four is better than seven.
Yes.
The sharp rate rises haven't helped Philip Lowe's popularity, but when we look at what inflation is doing, do you think the hikes have worked?
Yeah, the tables are turning a little bit. You know, the man was billed by many as public enemy number one, and let's be clear, you know, that whole rates won't rise till 2024 playbook, you know, that was a disaster for him. But he may just end up being the magician that pulls a rabbit out of a hat. You know, everyone said this could not be done, that we were in for a hard landing, that a recession was coming by the end of the year. But right now, they're on track. I mean, things still could go south. And for many families, they feel financially like they've fallen out of a plane and hit the tarmac. Mm. But, you know, when you're looking at the big picture, people are still in jobs. This is a really good thing.
So if we do see another pause, it's a pause, not a cut.
It is not a cut.
Is that any relief for people who have a mortgage?
It is no relief, Jane. And let's be clear here. You know, things are still going to get tougher. Most families with a mortgage, a variable mortgage, still haven't paid for rate hike number 12. Oh. So, you know, oh, sorry, they have just started paying for rate hike number 12. Sorry. Yeah. I was a month behind there.
That's okay.
So in total, their repayments have risen by $1,134 on a $500,000 mortgage. You know, this is huge, but also prices are still going up at the shop. Inflation, just remember, it doesn't mean prices are going down. It means they're going up, but slower pace than they were before. And so we're in for a tough time. Think of this as a marathon. There is a lot of pain still to come. You've just got to keep your head down, create weekly, monthly goals to get yourself through. Just know it's going to hurt, but it, you know, there may be a relief in 2024. Time will tell.
Is there any chance rates could rise again, and what would that do?
Oh, it absolutely could rise again, and certainly NAB is still forecasting one more rate rise before the end of the year. If that happened on that $500,000 mortgage, you're looking at $78 extra a month. You know, the total is climbing over, the increase that is, to $1,200. That's crazy. On a $1 million mortgage, you're looking at $152 extra a month. You know, their total is $2,421. If that rate rise comes. Again, if you've got a mortgage, plan for that rate rise to happen. If it doesn't happen, then you've got an extra bit of a buffer in your mortgage.
So we know Michelle Bullock will be taking over as the RBA governor later this month. She's already on the board. Is that going to change things at all? And we know that her focus will be bringing inflation down to that 2 to 3% bracket. Can she do it?
Yes, she can, and they have to. It's a not negotiable for the RBA. It's one of their key KPIs. They've got to get it between 2 and 3%. But what Governor Lowe has said repeatedly is that they're prepared to take their time. And so right now, the RBA forecasts don't have inflation hitting the top of that target band until the middle of 2025. That's almost 2 years away. Right. And so we're going to see prices keep climbing for a couple of years. There's no relief there. But, you know, what they're trying to do is chase a rainbow. They want to keep the gains, the huge gains we've had in the employment market. They want to keep people in jobs and bring prices down. They think they can do both. You know, let's see if they can do it. I think it's a good strategy. I do not see Governor Bullock changing that playbook.
It is not an easy job, is it? Sally Tindall, thank you so much for your time this morning. Let's take in the day's other news now. And the Australian dream of owning a home is pretty much just a dream for a lot of people. New research is showing that most young people will rely on an early inheritance in order to be able to make a first home purchase feasible. David, 70% of first home buyers did receive some financial support from their families. Is this just how we do things in Australia?
Yeah, we've got to do things differently. This is about supply, and I think it's also an honest conversation about going up, not out, because that's how you get supply in quickly, is to get dense, high-density living, not a $10 billion punt where you hope you can invest, you can make an investment that'll get more than what you're borrowing, which is what the government wants to do. We need state and local government to get on with the job of making it easy for capital to get in there, private capital to go and actually get the stock in there. That's how you do it, and that's how, hopefully, along with an honest conversation, that you may not have a quarter acre block anymore or a 400 square metre block, you might be in a unit. That's an honest conversation we've got to have as well.
Gus, does this mean we're going to make the divide even larger? You know, if you've got parents who already own a home, it's easier for you to own a home. And if your parents can't help you, well, what hope do you have?
Exactly. That's just the basics of it, you know. And certainly in our situation, we put a couple of granny flats out the back of our place so our kids, when they're a little bit grown up, can be there to at least keep saving and so forth. But not being able to buy a house in the place where you've grown up, which is your local area, which you know and love and stuff, is just literally the way it is going to be now. That's the reality of it, because everything's just way too expensive.
Sure.
And obviously getting money now from the banks are even more expensive too. So, yeah, it's a real issue.